This set of fiddle tunes is a fairly new set. It's written with, there again, the inspirations of my life in my new home. My new home, we call it Two Chimneys. Has two chimneys, one fireplace. But we have fun in it anyway. It's a gorgeous little place, and every morning I get up, and this is a very typical scenario for first thing in the morning. I get up in the morning and I'll go outside and I'll cross the little bridge and I stop at the creek that runs in front of our house and I'll look, and somewhere, either up or down the stream, will be the majestic blue heron. And he'll be out there standing around, looking very proud of himself, and then all of a sudden he'll dip that graceful head down and he'll start poking under the rocks and turning the rocks over with his feet and poking again and turning the rocks and poking again. What he's doing is it's breakfast time. And he's looking for the crawdads. Now, the crawdads don't want to be breakfast. They're very cranky. They get very cranky and crabby, as crawdads are wont to do. And they scurry themselves underneath, way deep underneath the rocks. And they wait. And as the blue heron will go and poke around, they'll go and tweak at his toes, you know, while he's poking around. If he sticks his beak down there, they'll grab a hold of his beak. And, you know, he'll pull his head up and here's a little crawdad going, ha-ha! They all shake his head and fling the crawdad, and the crawdad goes flying. Ha-ha, I get to live another day. Ha-ha, you know. Goes into the creek again and scurries under the rocks and plays the same game. By this time, I've walked up the hill, up to the barn, to let the horses out, and I'll open up the barn door, and out pops Millennium Mouser Mittens. That is our barn cat. Now, she's about 2 years old, and she's about as proud of herself as she could possibly be, and thinks that she is the most wonderful creature, that her face should be carved upon the moon. So, she will come popping out of the barn, and she'll go straight down to the creek, and go straight to the blue heron. And she'll fluster him into his 6-foot wingspan, and he'll take off. That leaves the cranky crawdads at her tender mercy. However, they will continue to do the very same game that they used to do to the heron. And I will hear the splash, 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 wow, and a crawdad goes flying. So, given that scenario, these three creatures, I decided I would write tunes for them. And so the first one is titled The Blue Heron. The second one is Cranky Crawdads. And the third one is Mittens on the Moon.